Hello folks, I am Alemaster and welcome to this tutorial. In today's video I'm going to explain how you can make cuttable grass, which involves the cut grass mechanic, the attachment to an animation, and the usage of particle systems and sound effects. Alright, as you can see, I've already opened up my project. I am on version 4.26, and for the cuttable grass we will need a few things first. The first thing is a grass mesh, of course. And we will need to check if it has collision. To do this, I go to the top, collision, select simple collision, and nothing changes. To add collision to my mesh, I go to the top left to collisions and add box simplified collision. Then the box that stands for the collision of the mesh appears, and I can hit save and close this window. Next, of course, is material for this grass. And the third thing we will need is a grass texture that we will need for the Niagara particle system we are creating later. So the first step of creating cuttable grass is to create a copy of the mesh. So I right click on the mesh and select duplicate, and I call this one cut grass. And the same I'm going to do with the material. In my case, this material is already a material instance of a master grass material. In your case, it might be just a simple material. So if it's a simple material, you can right click and create a material instance. In my case, it's already instance, so I right click and select duplicate, and I call this material cut grass material. Next step is to go to the cut grass mesh again and apply the newly created material. I called it cut grass material. Let's hit save and close. So now you might notice that the grass meshes are exactly the same, but one of them will be a cut version. So to achieve this, we will manipulate the material itself. For this, let's create a material function by right-clicking in the content browser here. Go to Materials and Textures and to Material Function. And I call this cut height material function. Let's open up the material function, ignore the error message, and then go on by creating some nodes here. At first, I right-click and type linear gradient. From the V gradient, I drag out a line and type linear interpolate, which will create a lerp. From the B, I drag out a line and type just constant and set the value of the constant to 1. And for the alpha, I drag out the line and type scalar parameter. And I'm going to call this one cut height and set it to a value of 1. And the output of the lerp, I drag out the line again and type multiply and connect the output of the multiply to the output result. And one input is missing from the multiply. So from the B, I drag out the line and type input. And select function input. And for the function input on the left, for the input name, I type opacity mask. And the input type will be a scalar. So the material function is finished. I can hit apply and save and close this down. Next, I go to my material of the cut grass. And since it's already a material instance, I need to go to the bottom here where it says parent and select my master material grass. And here I search for my opacity mask. Since we are working with grass, each grass material should have an opacity mask in most cases. Next, I right-click somewhere here and type function call and select material function call. And while it is selected, on the left I can choose my newly created function. I call this cut height material function. And now I double click on the line that connects to the opacity mask. And from the point that has been created, I drag out a line to the input of my material function, and the result goes into the opacity mask. I now can hit apply and save. And now I can show you what this material function actually does. When I now go to my cut grass material instance, let's open it up. There should be a parameter called cut height. And to get a better preview, I select my cut grass mesh and then select this little button on the bottom right of this window here. And the actual mesh, which is attached to this material, will show up. Now when I manipulate the cut height smaller, smaller and smaller, you will see at one point it appears like the grass has been cut. And this is what we want to achieve for this at the moment. So a value of minus 7.6 should be good for me now. So I can hit save and close this one. And now you can see in the preview window already the cut grass mesh appears smaller and cut. The next step now is to actually place the grass in the world. For this I'm going to look for a place where I can place my grass. This looks good, so I go to the modes on the top left and select foliage. Let's first delete some parts or a spot where I want to place my new grass. Okay, now you are going to drag the cuttable grass mesh to the foliage types and the cut grass to the foliage types. Then deselect the cut grass, so only the cuttable grass is selected. And we now have to set some settings here. For the density, this is okay in my case. The scale should be a little bit bigger for my grass in this case. And very important now is to activate collision on this cuttable grass mesh. So on the collision presets, select custom, collision enabled, set to query only, and the collision response, first select ignore all, and then select on the visibility channel block. This should be all settings we need for the cuttable grass, and now I can place some instances here. Okay, looks good. Let's try in game. All right, looks good so far. So the next very important step is to place one single instance of the cut grass in your world. If you don't have a instance of cut grass in your world, the whole system won't work. I uncheck the cuttable grass and select the cut grass. And for the density, I just type 1 and place it somewhere nobody ever will look at. So it has been placed. Okay, two instances, but no problem. And now we are ready to go on. All right, all the cutting grass magic will happen in the character blueprint. So I search for my character blueprint and open it up. And I search here for the begin play event. I just place the sequence here so I can not destroy my project. First, what we need to do is to get the foliage instances in the world at the begin play. To do this, from the begin play, drag out a line and type get all actors of class. And for the select class, choose foliage, instance foliage actor. Then from the out actors, drag out the line and type get. And select get a copy. If you don't have this one, don't forget to check the context sensitivity checkbox on the top. So get a copy. And from here, drag out another line and type get components by class. And here from the components, I again search for foliage instance static mesh component. And for the return value, I drag out the line and type for each loop. And I connect the for each loop to the output of the get all actors of class. Then from the for each loop from the array element, I drag out the line and type get static mesh, select the very bottom here. And from there, I drag out the line and type equals. And for the select asset, I select the cut grass mesh. Make sure it's a cut grass mesh, not a cutted grass mesh. And then from the boolean return value, I drag out the line and type branch. And this one I'm going to connect to the loop body. And again, from the for each loop, from the array element, I drag out the line and select promote to variable. And I call this one instance to add. And I connect this one to the true of the branch. So what is this going to do? On begin play, we get the for each instance actor in the world. Usually only one should be present, so we get the first index in the world. From the for each instance actor, we get all components. All components is, when I go to modes again, to foliage, all instances that have been placed in the world, all meshes. All these meshes, we compare if one of them is a cut grass mesh. And if this is the case, we add it to an instance variable that we can add later, which I will show you in the next step. Let's hit compile and save. The plan now is, if the character collides with one of these grass meshes, the grass mesh will be replaced by a cut grass mesh. And to do this, we go on by the event tick. Don't worry, we won't use this tick, but it's just for testing of the source system. From your event tick, drag out the line and type sphere trace by channel and select multi-sphere trace by channel. Again, make sure it's a multi-sphere trace by channel. The single sphere trace by channel won't work properly. So the sphere trace will be attached to my sword. My sword in this case is this sword here. I select it and it's called Master Sword One Hand Component. And on the right, I click on my static mesh, on the sword static mesh. And here I'm going to add sockets for this. Sockets which will define the lengths of the sphere trace. Let's create two sockets. Create socket. And I call this one. And another socket, and I call this one too. So my socket one I place on the tip of my sword, and the socket two I place on the end of the blade, somewhat like here. Then I can hit save and go to my character blueprint again. Next, in the event graph, left to my multi-sphere trace by channel, I drag my sword to the editor, and from my sword component, I drag out a line and type get socket location once, and I duplicate this and connect it. And for the socket name, I select one, and the second socket name is two. The one goes into the start, and the second goes into the end. For the radius, I choose a value of 20, and the trace channel is visibility, which is okay. And to test this, I just hit compile. And to test this, I select the drawn debug type and select for one frame, hit compile, minimize this window and go into my level again. And now you can see, I hope you can see in YouTube, there is a sphere around my sword. And the plan is, if my sword collides with the grass will be replaced with the cut grass. And to do this, I go to my character blueprint again. And from the multi-sphere trace by channel, I drag out a line from the return value and type branch. Then from the out hits, I drag out a line and type again for each loop. and connect the execution of the for each loop to the true of the branch. And from the array element of the for each loop, I drag out a line and type break, hit the result, and select this little arrow on the bottom here. And then I want to check what components have been hit. So I drag out the line from the hit component and cast to foliage instance static mesh component. And the result of the loop body I connect to the cast to foliage instance static mesh component. Okay, and next is to drag out the line from the foliage instance static mesh component and type instance transform, get instance transform, and it asks for instance index. In this case, it's the hit item of the break hit result, and the word space checkbox needs to be selected. Next, we are going to grab the variable we have created on the begin play here, instance to add. So I right click here and type instance to add, get instance to add, and from here I drag out the line and type add instance. And for the instance transform, I just connect it to the out instance transform of the other one here. And then I connect the add instance to the foliage instance static mesh component. What this will do, it will place and cut grass mesh at a position of a regular grass mesh in world. But to see this, we have to remove the regular grass mesh. So from the foliage instance static mesh component, I drag out the line and type remove instance. And this I connect to the add instance and the instance index. Again, I connect to the break hit result of the hit item. Now it's time for testing. I can now hit compile and save and go into my game. And now when my sword hits the grass mesh, it should be replaced with a cut grass mesh. And as you can see, it's the case. And if I walk through my grass meshes, they all get replaced by cut grass meshes. But now we have one problem. When my character walks through the grass, it will get cut automatically. But I don't want it to cut automatically. I want it to be cut when my character swings the sword. So to do this, I go to my character blueprint again and go to the top left where it says mesh. In my case, it's the character mesh, skeletal mesh, and on the right where it says skeletal mesh, I double click on it. And on the top right, I click on the animation. And I assume that you already have attack animations or whatever animations you want to use for cut grass. In this case, I use attack animations. And what we are going to do now, you have to do for all animations that will be used for cutting grass. I will show you this on one animation I'm using here. Oh, that's the wrong one. Let's pause this. When the sword swing starts, I add a notify track and go to the position where the sword swing might start, like here. And I right click here, add a notify and add a new notify. And I call this one can cut. And the same I'm going to where the cutting grass action should stop, at this place here, for example. And again, I right click here, add a new notify, and I call this one can not cut. Now I have two new animation notifies. From these, I can start and stop the grass cutting. I'm going to do this by go to the animation blueprint on the top right here. On the blank space, I right click and type can cut. And again, right click and type can not cut. And from the first can cut, I drag out the line and here I type function by name. And here I select set timer by function name, and the function name will be cut grass. And for the time I select or choose 0.01 and make it looping. This will basically act like a tick event that fires the sphere trace by channel in a loop. Nearly the same we are going to do for the cannot cut. Drag out the line and type pause timer by function name. And here for the function name we have to use the same name, cut grass. And for the object we use the owner of the animation blueprint, which is usually the character blueprint. So we can just right click and type get owning actor, and the return value gets plugged into the object here. So now this timer is looking for a function in the character blueprint. In this function we can now replace the tick with. So I'm going to right click and type add custom event and call this the same name as in the set timer by function, cut grass. Make sure it's absolutely the same writing, capital letters, small letters, and then we can replace the event tick by the cut grass here. And be careful, don't forget to unplug the multisphere trace from your event tick. Okay, now the cut grass fires whenever my animation plays in a certain range. So let's hit compile and save, and now it's test time. Let's first just walk through the grass. Okay, nothing has happened. And now when I play a certain animation, the grass is cut. And don't forget, your other animations need those animation notifiers too. Just use the same names and all your animations will cut the grass. Alright, the cutting grass now works fine. But to have a more immersive experience, we need to add some sound here and maybe some particle effects. To do this, let's go to the character blueprint again. Go to the cut grass event to the very end here, where the instance is removed. And let's add a sound effect. So drag out the line and type play sound 2D and select it in a set. I luckily already have a cut grass sound. Cut grass. It sounds like this. Maybe not the best, but we'll do the job. So let's just hit compile and save and test it. Whenever I cut the grass now. It will play the sound. Okay, and to make it even more immersive, we can add a particle system to the grass cutting mechanic. To do this, we are going to use the grass particle texture. So we are going to right click on it and create a new material. And then open it up. And on the grass particle texture material, on the blend mode, select masked and connect the alpha to the opacity mask. And if you want, you can modify your texture to match the color of your grass. Like I do, but you don't have to. Okay, once the material is finished, you can hit apply and save. And then it's time to create a Niagara particle system. So let's right click into the content browser, go to FX and select Niagara system. New system from selected emitters I select, and then I select omnidirectional burst, double click on it and hit finish. And I call this one cut grass emitter. Let's open it up. And on the very bottom where it says sprite renderer, for the material I select my material that I used for the particle system. It was called grass particle texture mat, okay. Grass particle texture material. All right. Now let's edit some values here. For the spawn burst, spawn count of 3 is okay, I think. Sphere location 40 is also look okay. The lifetime is a little long for my taste. Let's set it to 0.5 and 1. And the scale sprite size, let's set it to 40. I don't know if 40 is too big. Let's place it in world and check this out. Yeah, 40 might be okay. All right, for the drag, maybe I can reduce this more. Okay. I'm not really the Niagara guy, so you can do as you wish on this one and tweak this one as you like. But for me, this is okay. So now let's put this Niagara system into the character blueprint. In the character blueprint again, we have to spawn the Niagara system. But before the instance is removed, so we can get its location. So after the add instance, drag out a line and type spawn system add location and connect this to the remove instance again. For the system template, let's select the cut grass emitter we just created, and for the location, we use the location of the get instance transform. Let's drag out the line and type break transform and connect these to the rotation, location and scale. Okay, now it's time for testing again. Let's hit compile and save. And play the game. And now, when I hit the grass, I have a sound and an emitter. One thing you might want to add to the emitter is shadow, because out of the box shadows for Niagara emitters are disabled. So from the spawn system at location, I drag out a line and type shadow. Set cast shadow, connect it and connect it back to the remove instant, and set new cast shadow to true. And hit compile and save. It might be a subtle difference, but adds a little blue immersion. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. I hope it was what you were expecting. I hope you liked it. If so, then leave a like. And if you get any questions or suggestions, just leave a comment below. And also thanks to my Patreons. And if you want to become a Patreon and support me and my channel too, I will leave a link in the description. And if you like this tutorial and want to see more like this in future, consider subscribing and don't forget the bell icon. See you next time. Bye.